Hey guys, just thought I'd give you a little heads up. This video turned out to be over an hour long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to split it into three different parts, just to make it easier, a little bit more bite-sized chunks. So enjoy the video. Thank you. Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Conan Exiles Guides, Episode 3. Building your first base. So at the end of the last video, we created our character and I talked a little bit about the gods and what they give you. We decided to go with Mitra. So we've just started on this server and let's go on about building our first base. One thing that's very important to notice when you first start the game is pick up this water skin on the rock. It makes such a huge difference. I actually forgot to do that last server that I played on, and it was really tough with getting water. You have to run to the river all the time. So that's really helpful. Is it full to start with? It's got a little bit in it, so we'll drink some water. There we go, that's handy. Wow, what's going on with my hair there? It's all sort of shiny and pink looking. No, it doesn't look like that. No, so I think we're all good. Wow, what a stunning man I am. Alrighty. Let's go and I think we should start picking some branches up. We need branches. We need to get some plant fiber too. Make us some clothes. Oh, I've gained another level. I'm gaining levels fast. Get all this plant fiber. Let's make us some clothes. One, two. Let's make a pickaxe as well, why not? Could always do with a pickaxe. Alrighty, wow. Let's level up. How am I level 8 already? Wow, that's crazy. I am playing on a server with increased experience. So we'll get all the building stuff to start with, because this is what I'm doing it for. I'm showing you guys how to build your first base, and some good designs for your first base as well. Why not? Get all these bits that I need. Get the window. Wedge blocks are useful. Oh, I need level 9 for those. Alright. Put some points in strength, vitality. I really like putting just points in strength and vitality. They help you fighting stuff. Grit is very important for running away, and encumbrance for carrying stuff. I never play a game without loads of encumbrance. Let's pick up some more fiber as we go. We've got our pickaxe. Can we harvest these rocks yet? Patch note said we can harvest the black rocks in the desert. It doesn't seem that we can harvest these ones. Maybe we can harvest these ones. No. Alrighty then. Maybe it was lying. Maybe they're different black rocks. I don't know. Definitely can't harvest these rocks. No. Alright, never mind. I don't want to harvest these rocks anyway. Maybe it means you can just pick up those little black ones. Who knows? Oh, the demon! I still haven't fought one of those yet. I'd love to fight one. And I keep flying away every time I start a new character. Okay, let's take our long trip away from the desert. Oh wow, looks like someone's got a nice big base up here already. That looks pretty cool, building on top of the rocks. Where are we? We are right here. Okay, not a bad place to start. Typically, I recommend you start your first base around the river area. You don't want to head too far north just yet. It makes it kind of difficult to find some iron later on, but the stuff up there is really tough to kill. It can really overwhelm you quite easily, especially the spiders and the rhinos. The rhinos, they really hurt. So that guy's got a nice base up there. Interesting little stairway up to there. Uh-oh. don't really want to fight these imps. And of course, it's nighttime. It's always nighttime. Always nighttime when you want to record. It's just harvest these rocks and hope none sees us. Alright, so nighttime's over. I was busy collecting stuff at night. Start off making some sandstone foundations. Let's make a few of those. We're going to level up now. I'm going to get this wedge blocks. Okay. What do we need? The fences, they're very useful. And that's pretty much all we need to start off with. We can get the iron pick and the iron hatchet. We'll learn that as well. That's really useful. We also want to start off getting us a sword and shield. Just so we can defend ourselves a little bit. What do I need? I need some twine. Well, we can make some twine, that's not a problem. Let's make 10 of those. Still need to make some more twine. And let's make us a shield as well. Lovely. So we've got a way to defend ourselves now. Pick up all these branches while we can. And let's go and find a nice little place to build a house. Also, try not to die. There's a couple of imps here. Let's fight those off. Swiftly dealt with. Silly imps. So it's nice to find somewhere that's close to water. It's always nice to have some water nearby. But we don't want to go anywhere too far north. It's quite a nice little building design this person's got here. Got a nice little place by the river. All these imps outside though, I think I'd be irritated with that. I like the little design they've got, the little inset. Pretty cool. Nice arch towers on the corner. Lovely. Alrighty. Let's have a little swim. I'd like to build something maybe a little bit further to the north so I don't have to run quite as far to get iron. Typically the iron only spawns sort of in the middle to the north of the map. And it's really important to have iron. You need iron to make all of the tier 2 weapons and armor and tools, and you need iron to make steel, which makes the tier 3 weapons and armor and tools, so it's really an important thing to get. There's lots of big bases in this server now. Let's try and find our own little place to settle down. Where are we heading? Okay. Might be nice to head up somewhere around this area here, maybe even here. Have a look. It might be a little bit too far north there. Things might be getting a little bit tough. There's a crocodile there. That's a really important thing to stay away from as a new player. Crocodiles really suck. They will kill you in the blink of an eye. Like literally a third of your health every time they hit you, which is a lot. So stay away from crocodiles. Let's have a look. A lovely little village there next to the river. Very nice, very nice. It's an interesting design for a building with lots of different balconies. I'm not sure how you could choose which one that you'd want to pick to sit out on a sunny day. Oh, there's a hyena. Oh, there's quite a few hyenas. Okay. Maybe this wasn't such a great idea. There are lots of hyenas here. Like a lot of hyenas. And they're all gonna come for me, aren't they? Oh, there's another one. And this is exactly what I mentioned about venturing north of the river. There's lots of things that want to eat you up. Let's make a bedroll, because I really don't want to have to run. So let's see where we can pop this down. Let's pop this down right here next to all these hyenas, so that when we spawn back, we'll have to fight a load of hyenas. That sounds like a great idea. It really doesn't sound like a good idea at all, but it's done now. This is a nice little place here next to the waterfall, set into the rock. Got the little crafting stations outside. To apologise for my terrible FPS. This game's still not optimised very well. It is still in early access. It's only been out for about 3 weeks now, so they're still adding fixes almost daily during the development weekdays, which is nice. So that would be a nice little place for a base right there. It's a shame there's a thrall camp there. I don't really want to spawn that. Let's have a little look further up. Okay, this might be a nice little spot up here, right next to the bridge. We could have a toll bridge, we could charge people to cross. Whereabouts are we on the map? We're about here. There's a little path that goes up into the mountains. Oh, someone's made a little base up there maybe. Let's have a little look up there. So I'm trying to look for a place now that's fairly close to getting iron. I want to be as close to the middle of the map as possible without having to deal with the really nasty guys. Okay, so that just looks like it goes to the south. It's a lovely little area. Oh, there's a rhino up there. Lovely little area, but there's not really any access to the north unless I chase up this river valley here. Let's just go for it, guys. Let's just go as far north as we can and see how it works. Maybe we'll die, but we've got that bedroll. So bedrolls allow you to spawn on them once after you die, which means that after you die, you need to place another one down really quickly in case you die again. Let's just run away from that shale back. It's chasing us. Ooh, that was a cave. Oh, that's full of spiders. I do not want to go in there. I do not like spiders. Okay. Lovely little river valley here. This would be a lovely place for a base. Oh, and someone's already claimed it. Look at that. And a crocodile. And hyenas. Oh, no. Crap, I have to take care of this hyena because we don't want it to slow us down while we're running away from this crocodile. Coming pretty quickly. Someone's got a lovely little base. Oh, why are there bones everywhere? Don't like the look of that. Does that mean there's something dangerous nearby? There's certainly hyenas right here. Gained a level. Awesome. Okay. So it looks like we're roughly around the area we wanted to be. It's a nice big walled city right there. Got a nice little place. Oh, this is quite pretty. There's crocodiles here, which isn't perfect. But it's a pretty nice area. Maybe we could settle here. Ideally, I'd like to settle right where that crocodile lives. Let's have a little look around. I think I'm going to place another bedroll down. Just because here's a place I'd like to come back to. So, after you place a bedroll down, guys, I'm sure you're all aware, but remember to authorize it. You have to click on it, otherwise it won't remember you've used it. I really hope they change that. The amount of times that I've died and I've been like, oh, it's fine, I put down a bedroll. and I spawned in the desert. Now I had to run all the way across the map again. Okay, so we've got some iron here. These little rocks here are iron. That's going to be really good. And there's spiders, which is really bad. So we don't want to go that way. Is that a cave down there as well? I really want us to build a base right next to a cave. Oh, there's rhinos. Oh, there's everything scary here. Well, you know what? This doesn't look like a bad place. Got a lovely little view of the river here. All of the rhinos and hyenas are down there, and all of the spiders are up there. So I think we're going to start here. So let's start by placing our first block. Now, building your first base, it's important to have enough space for your carpenter and your blacksmith and your tannery. So we need to make it decent enough sized. We don't need a huge amount of space. But let's try and line it up so that it's flat with the edge of the cliff there. Going to have a look, see what the line is across there. Alright. The line's flat that way. I want to try and put my first block about here, I think. There we go. First block's placed. So we'll put all these other ones down. We'll head over to the edge of the cliff here just to make sure that we're lined up nice and neatly. I'm going to go for a fairly simple base design. I don't think there's really any need to be extravagant. Let's chop down this tree, get some more materials. We need to go and get some rocks, so that's good. Okay, I am really over-encumbered now. This server's got a gather modification, as you might be able to tell. You harvest a lot more materials per hit than on a vanilla server. Which is really handy if you're trying to do a video like this one and show people how to build stuff. I don't have enough resources. I ran out of rocks. Well, that was silly of me. So let's start off by building a regular 3x3 little base here. So it's 3 wide and 3 long of the square foundations. Now let's start by adding in some triangle foundations. The triangle foundations allow you to customize the shape of your base. You can make it a little bit more unique. Unfortunately, these triangles, although they look like right angles, they're not like right angles, unfortunately. So you can't put a triangle and then a square, and then a triangle connecting them in between. It just doesn't work. So you have to then switch over to using triangular foundations if you want to use a slightly more unique base design. So what I want is I want a nice little balcony, just like this little round one here. It's not really round, but a more rounded area. We can have a look over the water. I'm going to get rid of this bush, though, because it's really bugging me being in the way like that. There we go. So let's have a nice little entrance porch as well. We'll do similar to what we've done on the other side. Not enough resources. Let's go and gather some more rocks. And this is Conan Exiles building in a nutshell. Run out of wood, go and collect more rocks. Go and collect more wood. Go and collect more rocks. Go and collect more wood. That's pretty much how the building side goes. Obviously, once you start getting into the tier 2 buildings, then things start getting a lot more interesting. You have a lot more options of things to build. You also need a lot more different materials, so it takes a lot longer to build things. So we'll just go with a little two little blocks in the front here. As you can see now, we've changed this basic, boring 3x3 shape into something a little bit more interesting. It's more like a capsule. Pill sort of shape. So we could make this more interesting again. We could go out another way this way. We could go out another way this way. You know what I think I'm going to do? I think I'm not enough resources. I think I'm going to just go out in a little square section. I don't think we need any more of the triangular foundations just yet. So let's gather up more than we need. Unfortunately, we can't move. So let's do some craftings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's how many I want. So let's build out this way, this way, this way, and then the same again on the other side. Now why am I doing this, you ask? Well, a lot of the crafting stations handily are shaped just to fit into a corner. So if this is my entrance place here, which is how I think it'll be, I can come in here and I've got crafting stations in the side. They're not going to be in the way of the main area. Now I can build up to the second story, which is nice, so I'm going to do that as well. I think first of all we need to make some stairs to the front of our house and a doorway. Then we can sort of really plan our design. So an important thing to notice when you place things is which way it's facing. You can scroll through the mouse wheel to change which way it's facing. Now reading it as outer face means that the outer face is towards me. So I want the outer face the other way around, facing the outside of the building. There we go, so that's the outer face. You can see the inner face here has all these wood support structures. So that is lovely. Stairs, just want some stairs, or just clip into the floor a little bit, just so we don't have to jump up all the time. Lovely. Let's make some more stairs. I think I want some stairs to the second floor. Going up like this. Because I want to have a balcony on top of my balcony. I know, I already complained about someone having too many balconies as we were walking up here, but that's besides the point. I like balconies. Call me a hypocrite. Harvest more rocks. I think we need to get some normal walls going up. So let's start building. Let's start with a couple of windows first. I think maybe another doorway for the other side, and then let's just craft a load of walls. We're going to use loads of walls anyway, so I'm not too bothered about having too many walls. So let's use our other doorway here. So I'm making sure that the outer face is pointing outside. Let's put our windows and our walls on our hotbar. So I'd quite like to have a window either side of the doorway. Although that just looks nice to me. Okay, so when you're trying to place something here but something's in the way, you can always go and face the other way. Just make sure that the outer face reads outer face and it's not back to front. You don't have to destroy the things you've just made. Okay, so get all these bottom level window or bottom level walls up, even. One of those words. This is the sort of the general, going to be the general crafting area. I think I'll make another set of stairs for the other side, heading up the top here. I've got a nice little idea to make this a fairly nice sized place. Alrighty. I want to make some fence foundations next, just to sort of tidy this place off a bit. I think we need to repair our pickaxe. I really hope that they add a way to repair things in the game, other than just manually clicking on everything and then hitting repair in the game. It's really tiresome. And really slow. Now you can repair things directly from the hotbar if they're broken. You just press this corresponding number on the hotbar. But you can't do that for clothes unless you put all your clothes on the hotbar, which is going to be a nightmare really. Let's repair our sword as well. Let's make some of these. So we've got, how many do we need? So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we need to make 9 fences. Let's just make 10. Why not? I'll put those on the hotbar as well. There's no real benefit to having an entranceway like this. This is just purely for aesthetics. I like places that look nice, so may as well make somewhere that looks nice. Alrighty. We'd probably better build a door, hadn't we?